Hi guys, so today we will learn about the pet animal nutrition, the part 2. We will learn about the energy requirement and different nutrient requirement in a very detailed manner. This is very important for students, okay, but the pet parents can watch it and they can take a gist of it. So first of all, the energy, it is expressed in kilocalorie per day. And it is calculated in a thermoneutral environment, that is 20 to 22 degrees Celsius. Okay, in this environment, the basal metabolic rate is optimum. Next, we should know the MER, the maintenance energy requirement. Before that, we should know RER, the resting energy requirement. Okay, for the calculation of RER, we have two formulas, the exponential formula and the linear formula. The exponential formula is basically valid for all type of body weight, whereas the linear formula is valid for the body weight ranging from 2 to 45 kg. So first of all, the exponential formula, it is 70 into body weight to the power 0.75. This is also known as the metabolic body weight. Okay, MBW, the metabolic body weight. So the exponential formula is 70 into metabolic body weight. Now the linear formula is 30 into body weight, this is in kg, 30 into body weight plus 70, but this formula holds good for 2 to 45 kg body weight. So after you knowing the resting energy requirement, now we will go for the maintenance energy requirement. For an adult intact dog, the maintenance energy requirement is 1.8 into RER, that is resting energy requirement. You see, for intact, nutrient, obese, prone, okay, you see the energy requirement decreases, okay. Why the intact has more energy requirement than nutrient? Because of the sex hormones, okay. The sex hormones are responsible for higher metabolism. That is why the intact adult dogs require more energy than nutrient dogs. Now, the obese, prone dog require less energy. Why? Because, you know, due to obesity, when they acquire more body weight, they usually tend to become less active. That is why their maintenance energy requirement reduces. So don't make your dog fat. Okay. Similarly, in case of cat, the intact adult cat has higher maintenance energy requirement than the neutered. That is 1.4 into RER. The neutered one will require 1.2 into RER. Next, the obese prone cats, some cats are very much prone to obesity, that is equal to resting energy requirement. You see the puppies, okay, notice this, the puppies has comparatively higher energy requirement, that is 3 into RER. This is very high than the, if you compare in a body weight or kgs, you will see this is very high, okay. Because the growth rate is very high in puppies, that is why they need more energy. Okay, so remember, energy comes from protein, fat, carbohydrate. Okay, these three are main sources of energy. We will discuss the nutrient, and there I will discuss the sources of protein, sources of fat, sources of carbohydrate, sources of fiber, everything. Next, puppies, you see the energy requirement decreases with the age. First 4 to 14 week, remember, this is the in this period the growth is highest, that is why 3 into RER, and more than 14 week it reduces to 2 into RER. In case of kittens, it is usually 2.5 times of RER. Let us take an example. Like dog of 20 kg. You see, this is 20 kg is body weight. Body weight is 20 kg. Now we have to calculate the metabolic body weight. Okay, metabolic body weight will be 20 to the power 0.75. It will come around 9.5 kg. Okay, if we will take this metabolic body weight of 9.5 kg and we will put in this formula, it will come as 665 kilocalorie per day. This is resting energy requirement. Even if you will put in linear formula, this is a kg, okay, it will come around 670 kilocalorie per day. There is not much of a difference, 5 kilocalorie per day is not a big deal, okay. So if we will calculate for that dog, if it is an intact dog or neutered or obese prone, you see the calorie requirement decreasing. In an intact 1197, whereas in neutered 1064, and in case of obese prone only 931 kilocalorie per day. Next, puppies, you see 630 kilocalorie per day. So compare this one with this one. This is 20 kg puppy. Suppose I will take example of puppy of 4 kg. You see 4 kg is a body weight. If I will calculate a metabolic body weight, it will come around 3 kg, 2.9 something or 3 kg. Okay, you see there is only 1 kg difference, where here you can see clearly 10 kg difference. So with age, the metabolic body weight reduces. That is why their comparatively energy requirement also reduces. And you see puppies for 4 to 14 week, 630 kilocalorie of day per day. Then after 14 week, it will come around 420 kilocalorie per day. Similarly, you take an example of cat of 3 kg and you calculate yourself. Okay, you calculate yourself what will be the intact adult cat requirement, neutered cat requirement, obese prone cat requirement, and for the kittens. Okay, now we will go for the individual nutrient requirement, starting from water to vitamins and minerals. So now the nutrients. First one is water. Water is actually very important in case of cats, because cats usually don't drink much water. That is why they become more prone to dehydration. Okay, if you see the cases coming to your dispensary or hospital of cases of diarrhea specifically, you will find the cats are more dehydrated than the dogs, because they usually take less water, and in diarrhea there is also there is loss of water. So the dehydration becomes more severe problem in case of cats than dogs. So please, the cat pet parents, please take care of this. Give as much as of water or any source of water. Okay, any vegetable which contains more water. Next, the water requirement 44 to 67 ml, 66 ml per kg body weight. Next, you should know this one also. You see the commercial preparations which are coming. The canned one has the highest water percentage, the dry ones. Suppose your cats or cat doesn't take much of water, then you can give some canned pet food which contains highest moisture content, so that the water will be absorbed. Next one, this is very very important, the protein. It is the basically the building block of the entire body. Okay, the protein. Now coming to the protein, the essential amino acids. Okay, this comes as objective questions in your examination, even in different entrance examination. You should remember the essential amino acids: the arginine, histidine, isoleucine, leucine, methionine, phenylalanine, threonine, tryptophan, and valine. You see, in case of cat, there is an additional one. This comes as very common sort of question, the taurine. And also there is an objective question: deficiency of taurine causes feline central retinal degeneration. Okay, I have written shortcut because of a lack of space. So you remember this one: feline central retinal degeneration and dilated cardiomyopathy. Okay, these two are diseases, deficiency of taurine. You can remember this like this short form. You can make your own short form, or like a hill in Madhya Pradesh turned to valley. Anything like that you can remember according to your suitability. Next one is source, the protein source. Okay, these are animal sources: the meat, egg white, milk, cheese, yogurt. These are animal sources. These are plant sources: lentils, basically dal, okay, beans and peas. Okay, also yeast, they are also good source of protein. Between these two, the egg white comes as a number one protein source because of high biological value. Then comes the meat, okay, second highest biological value. Next, you should know the commercial pet food which are available. They vary from the digestibility of on the basis of digestibility of protein, 75% to 90%. You see, biological value, I have given hint also and discussed some part in my previous lecture. The biological value basically depends on how much number of essential amino acids it contain, and also the digestibility of protein, whether it is a good digestible protein or not. Next, whether after digestion it can be metabolizable by the body or not. So, based on these three parameters, the biological value is determined. And you should know, remember, this also comes as a question, the egg white or egg has the highest biological value. Next, coming to the requirement. Okay. In case of adult dog, okay, 2.62 gram per kg of metabolic body weight per day. This is the requirement. Next, puppy, 4 to 14 week age, 9.7 gram per metabolic body weight per day. Next, puppy, 12.5 gram per kg of metabolic body weight per day. Next, the adult cat, the 3.97 gram per metabolic body weight per day. Kitten, 9.4 gram per metabolic body weight per day. You see, always the puppies or kittens, they need more protein because of it is a growth phase. In case of puppy, they are in growth phase. The bones will be formed, the muscles will be formed, the nerves will form. All require protein. Okay, so you need high protein diet in case of the puppy stage or kitten stage. That is why you need these sources. Pet parents, remember to include these sources when you are raising a puppy or kitten. You see, the animal sources are inevitable in case of cat. Okay. In cat, you cannot maintain in vegetarian diet. I already discussed, you can watch my previous video. So, this is all about the water and protein. Next, we will go for fat. Now, coming to the fat, one of the most important nutrient has some basics, like the dietary fat usually is triglycerides, which is basically formed by the fatty acid and glycerol. The triglycerides can be short chain, medium chain and long chain. The long chains are very important because these are basically essential fatty acids. They are basically long chain fatty acids. The fatty acids can be saturated and unsaturated. The saturated fatty acids is basically utilized for energy production. Why? The unsaturated fatty acids, they are the building blocks. They are part of cell membranes and lipoproteins. Okay. Now here comes a term, PUFA, polyunsaturated fatty acid, PUFA. Among them, their most popular are the omega-3 fatty acid, omega-6 fatty acid, omega-9 fatty acids. It's not omega-3, 6, 9 fatty acids, it's omega-3, 6 and 9 fatty acids. So essential fatty acid basically three: linoleic, arachidonic and linolenic. Linoleic is most important in case of dog. While if you have followed my previous lecture, you must be knowing the arachidonic acid is very important in case of cat. The linoleic, the arachidonic, they are basically omega 6 fatty acids, while the linolenic is omega 3 fatty acids. Now you must have seen the Horlicks ad. Okay. For the young infants, you must have known the DHA. Okay. For brain development, you must be knowing the DHA. Similar in case of puppies and kittens, this is also essential. This is a fatty acid. The docosahexaenoic acid is also DHA, and also the eicosapentaenoic acid is EPA. These two are very much important in case of puppies and kittens for better development. Another thing you must know, the commercial pet food, the adult one contains 5 to 15% of fat, while in case of puppy rations, they contain 8 to 20% of fat. Now the requirement in case of adult, it is 1.3 gram per metabolic body weight per day. For puppies, 5.9 gram per metabolic body weight per day. You see, this is nearly 4 times higher. Okay, you should remember. Again, I am saying also, I will be saying repeatedly, the puppies, they usually require more nutrient rather than the adults. So you should know when you are becoming the pet parent for first time, when you raise the puppies, okay, you don't raise the adults. So in case of puppies, they need more and more nutrient. So please take care of the nutrients. Next, the adult cat, 2.2 gram per metabolic body weight per day. The kittens, 4.7 gram per metabolic body weight per day. You see, even here also 2 times more fat is required in case of kitten rather than the adult cats. The sources, yolk, egg yolk, this is animal source, this is a very good source, okay, for fats. Apart from vegetarian source like nuts, corn oil, these are also source of fat. They're all the oils are source of good fat. Next, why the fat is important. You see, when you will be visiting your veterinarian for any dermatitis case, okay, dry scaly coat, okay, he will prescribe some coat supplement. If you will go through the ingredients, you will find mostly these essential fatty acids. Okay, these essential fatty acids play very vital role in the coat conditioning. Okay, so you should give the sources of essential fatty acid in your diet so that the coat conditioning should be maintained by the diet only, not by the supplement. Next, this is very important, the reproductive disorders. You will find the anisotropic cases where there will be fat deficiency and the testicular underdevelopment because the testosterone hormone is derived from fat. Next, lack of libido. Libido is basically desired for intercourse or sex. So if the animal is having fat deficiency, you will find less desire for intercourse. So this is all about the fat. Now we will go for the carbohydrate and fiber. Now coming to the carbohydrate. The carbohydrate is particularly very important in case of dogs because they synthesize the glucose from the dietary carbohydrate only. That is why they are very important. Unlike the cats, okay, in case of cats, they are not very much important because they can synthesize glucose from glucogenic amino acids and glycerol. Which one is a glucogenic amino acid, you can comment below, okay. Now, the carbohydrate is basically conditionally essential among all the nutrients. They are particularly very important in case of growth, gestation and lactation. This is basically the puppy stage in which there will be growth stage, or the, you can see the growth curve. In case of previous class, you have seen the growth curve. In that case, carbohydrate becomes very important because they are easily available source of energy. Next, some source, the breads, milk, fruits, grains and potato, they are very good source of carbohydrate. Remember one thing, like breads, the grains and potato, they contain starch. Okay, if they are not particularly very well cooked, it may cause flatulence and diarrhea. Okay, the pets cannot digest the starch, okay, the raw starch. So you need some treatment, that is cooking, before giving to the pets. Next, fiber, they are basically part of the carbohydrate. They are usually from the plant sources. Why they are essential? Because they act as a prebiotic. Remember, it's not probiotic, it's prebiotic. You know the difference between the prebiotic and probiotic? The probiotic is basically introduction of bacteria itself or the helpful organism itself, whereas the prebiotic is you introduce some nutrients which can boost up the already existing bacteria, that is prebiotic. So the fiber can be soluble and insoluble. Soluble are methyl cellulose and inulin. Insoluble is plain cellulose. There are some sources, beet pulp, psyllium. See, this is very commonly available. In every shop you will find psyllium, also inulin. So this is all about the carbohydrate. Now the vitamin and minerals, then we will end the class. Now coming to the last part, the vitamins and the minerals. For the vitamins, the sources are carrots, fish, spinach, lettuce, papaya, there are many more, you can google that. Okay, these are very balanced source of vitamins. Vitamins can be divided in fat soluble vitamin and water soluble vitamin. The fat soluble vitamins are vitamin A, D, E and K, while the water soluble vitamins are vitamin B and C. Vitamin, under vitamin there are many vitamins, okay, it is usually known as vitamin B complex. Next, stored in body, that is fat soluble, when they are given in an excess amount, they are stored in body, mostly they are stored in liver. They are basically not stored except vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is stored. You see, here is an exception, and this may come as an objective question, like in case of cats, vitamin K is not stored. You see, when they are given in an excess amount, very excess amount, they can cause toxicity, specifically vitamin A and vitamin D, while the water soluble vitamins do not produce toxicity because they are excreted out in urine. Okay, that is why they don't cause any toxicity. Here remember one thing, vitamin A is very important in case of cats. You see, carrots, most of them, I am taking an example, carrot, they contain beta carotene. The beta carotene, which is a precursor of vitamin A. Then the beta carotene is digested by the enzyme, the intestinal dioxygenase, to form the vitamin A. In case of cats, this enzyme is not present. Okay, they lack this enzyme, the intestinal dioxygenase. That is why they cannot convert the precursors, that is beta carotene, to vitamin A. So the cats particularly need preformed vitamin A in their diet. Specifically, vitamin A is found, you see, storehouse is liver. So any liver material, whether it is chicken, mutton or chevron, anything, or even if cod liver oil, fish liver, they contain vitamin A. That is why they are essential in case of cats, in the diet of cats. Now the minerals, remember this because they come as objective questions, macro minimal mineral and trace mineral depending on requirement. Okay, so the macro are sodium, potassium, calcium, phosphorus and magnesium, and the trace are iron, zinc, copper, iodine, fluorine, selenium and chromium. Okay, this one usually comes as such question, the macro minerals. You can remember by your short form, okay, like soda, khaki, calcium, phosphorus, manga. Anything, you can remember anything. So this is all about the nutritions in detail. Okay, their sources, pet parents who are watching, remember the sources. Okay, you incorporate the sources in their diet. Okay, remember, while raising a puppy, okay, during the growth period, try to give multiple diets. Okay, do not give only one commercial food diet or any single source diet. You see, already I have discussed in previous class, the single source diet may cause some deficiency diseases. So give a multi range of products for their growth and for diet, in their diet plan. Because you see, sometimes what happens, suppose you are giving single source diet, suppose you are giving rice and dal only. What will happen? Suppose there is some problem with animal, he or she may not take rice and dal, and he doesn't eat any other thing. So it will cause problem. If he or she has taste of many, like he eats rice, dal, chicken, fish and fruits, vegetables, anything, then even if he or she doesn't want diet, it can be maintained with other diets. Okay, so always give multiple diets or multiple range of products to your pets. So this is all about the pet nutrition. Next we will go for some managemental aspects like bathing, grooming, etc. Okay, so thank you. If you like this video, please share with your friends, colleagues, junior, senior. Also you can check out the different playlists under my channel. Like if you are a field surgeon, there its multiple playlist on field level surgery or field level anesthesia lecture, etc. And if you are a student, there are some surgery lecture videos in a series, veterinary courses series, also principles of surgery series. Or if you are a practitioner, there are many surgery series, large animal surgery or small animal surgery or pet animal surgery. So you can check out different playlists in this channel. So thank you. Bye bye.